Hi, today we have Citroen CLS. I'm going to show you how to change the cam belt. First we are going to open the hood. The cam belt is on this side. And we are going to start. First we are going to remove this protective cover. And now we are going to remove the fuel lines so we can open the cam belt protective plastic. We remove the fuel lines. It's easy, just press the two pieces and it can go out. Now we are going to remove the plastic cover. Now we have opened the bolts that hold the cam belt cover, and now we can remove it. You can see it has 4 bolts, and now we can see the cam belt. It looks like it's in a good condition. This is his first cam belt change. Now we can raise the vehicle, remove the front right wheel to... We have removed the front right wheel. Now we can remove the protective plastic so we can work on crankshaft and remove the wheel. We have removed the plastic cover under the wing. Now we can see the crankshaft pulley, the wheel, and everything. Now we can raise the vehicle. To remove the wheel, we are going to use, it needs a special key, but I'm going to use a 16mm wrench. Put it on the tensioner, and now we are going to turn the tensioner to the front and we can remove the wheel. And you can see now we have removed the wheel. Now we can raise the vehicle, drain the coolant, and to open the crankshaft pulley and lower protective plastic. Now we have raised the vehicle. First we are going to drain the coolant. Drain the coolant, we are going to open the lower hose of the radiator. And then we can remove the crankshaft pulley. You can tighten the metal clamp with this kind of pliers. Now we can remove the hose and the coolant is going to drain. Yeah. Now we can return the metal clamp, the hose, everything. Now we can insert in this hole here a bolt, and we can open the crankshaft pulley. We have opened the crankshaft pulley, now we can remove it, and now we can remove the protective cover for the cam belt. Also we can remove the bolt that we put in this hole, so we can turn the engine. We have opened all the bolts from the protective plastic, but we forgot something from the top side of the engine. Now we are going to lower the car to remove that part, so we can remove the plastic. We have to remove this engine support mounting because it's holding the protective plastic. To open it, there is one bolt from this side here with 12 millimeter wrench. This is the thing that was holding the plastic. Now you can see it's all free. We can raise the vehicle again to remove the protective plastic. And we have removed the protective plastic. Now we can remove the RPM sensor, crankshaft sensor. So we can remove the belt from the crankshaft pulley. And then we can lower again the vehicle to support the engine, to completely remove the cam belt. Now we are supporting the engine, so we can remove the engine mounting. First we are going to open these three bolts, and two are here, one, the other one is there. Remove the rubber mounting, and then we can remove the other aluminium mounting. We are opening the bolts with this kind of key. It's 50 millimeter. Now we can remove completely, just to remove this hose. Now we can remove completely the rubber mounting, and now we can remove the four bolts from the aluminium from the engine mounting, so we can remove the timing belt. We have removed the aluminium mounting. We use 16 millimeter wrench, and now the timing belt is free to be removed. First we have to turn the engine to the timing marks, and then we are going to insert the pins to lock the crankshaft and the camshaft. Now you can see we have set the camshaft and the timing pin, also the high pressure pump. You can see the hole where it's aligned, and the crankshaft. this little hole here. Now we are going to insert the pins to lock the camshaft and crankshaft, and we are going to remove the timing belt. You can see we have inserted the pin. This one is M6, 6 millimeter pin. Here we have 8 millimeter, and on high pressure pump we have 6 millimeter. Now we can open the tensioner with 13 millimeter wrench. That is this one here, and we can remove the timing belt. Now we have opened the tensioner, and we have released the timing belt. Now we can remove it. Now we can remove it also from the crankshaft, and the timing belt is removed completely. We can see there is no cracks, but it has passed 140 kilometers on this car. Now we are going to change it with new one. We are also going to remove the idler pulley. That one is with 16 millimeter wrench. We are going to open it and change it with new one. We have removed the idler pulley, and the last thing that we have to do is to remove the coolant pump. Remove the coolant pump, we need a 8 millimeter wrench key. We have removed the coolant pump. Be careful when you're opening, because there is a steel coolant. You have to put something to drain it. Here is from the beneath. Here is the pump. You can see it looks good, but if you don't change it, you can see here has a little grease, and maybe a coolant has little leaked. That's why we are changing it. The pump has made also 140,000 kilometers. That's a lot, and it's recommended to change it, because it can happen to leak the coolant. Now we are going to take the new set, new coolant pump, and I will show you how to install it. Here we have new set of cam belt and coolant pump. Here is the gasket, the timing belt, the tensioner, and the idler pulley. First we are going to install the coolant pump. Now on these two bolts the gasket is a little smaller, so you can install the bolts and you can align it that way. And now we can install the pump into its position. Now the coolant pump is tightened. Can see it's spinning very well. Now we can install the idler and now we can install the tensioner. You can see the tensioner has inserted a pin, so when we are going to tension the timing belt we can remove easily the pin. Now the tensioner goes like this and the adjusting procedure is anti-clockwise. And now we can install the timing belt. First we are inserting the belt on the crankshaft, on the idler pulley, camshaft, and now if needed we can adjust a little on the high pressure fuel pump, then goes to the tensioner and to the coolant pump. First we are turning the pump clockwise until it reaches the pin. Insert the timing belt. On this side the timing belt is tightened a little. So now when the tensioner is going to work, you can see now it's set at the middle. Now we have to adjust the tensioner. We are turning anti-clockwise with a 6mm hex wrench until this pin can be removed easily, and then we are going to tighten it with 13mm wrench. Now we have to remove all the pins from the camshaft and from the crankshaft so we can properly adjust the tension for the timing belt. We have adjusted the tensioner. The tension in the timing belt must be adjusted very properly. If too much tension, it will it will destroy the coolant pump. Also, it may break the timing belt. Too loose, also it can break the timing belt. We can check from the bottom. That's all we can see with the camera. It's very difficult to see with the camera because the place is not very available. Now we can remove the pin from the tensioner and we can check for the crankshaft and for camshaft is it okay with the timing. The pins must to be inserted freely. Now we can check for the high pressure pump. It's okay. And now we can check the crankshaft. Also that one ins and outs easy. And now we can continue. We are going to install the aluminium mounting. We are tightening the bolts, 16 mm wrench. Now we can install the rubber mounting. Here we have installed the rubber mounting. And now we can raise the vehicle to install the protective plastic for the timing belt and crankshaft pulley. We have raised the vehicle. Now we can install the plastic cover. I almost forgot the RPM sensor. First, the RPM sensor needs to be installed, but only this bolt has to be loosened so it can fit the RPM sensor. The RPM sensor now is tightened, the plastic is tightened. We are going to install the wire holders. Now we can install the crankshaft pulley. Now, like before, to tighten the crankshaft pulley, we need to insert bolt inside this hole. And now we can tighten it with 18 mm wrench. We have tightened the crankshaft pulley. Now we can remove the bolt from the hole. Now from the lower side of the car we have finished. Now we can install the plastic underwing and install the wheel. Here is the plaster underwing. Now we are going to install it. We have installed the plastic. It has a couple of bolts. Now we can lower the car. We have installed the wheel. Now we are going to install the protective cover for the timing belt. We have installed the protective cover. Now we can install Now we have to install two bolts for a cable bracket. Now we have to insert the fuel lines. And we have to bleed the system by pressing this button until it gets hard. And now we have to install the V-belt. The belt is inserted. We can remove the key. Now we have to fill with coolant. This car needs to bleed the system. We are going to use 2 liters of new coolant because the old one was too low minus temperature, and we have to open that cap to bleed the system when we are going to fill with coolant. Now you can see air bubbles are coming up with coolant, and it's going to start to leak all the time. Now we can close it. It's leaking good coolant. And fill with more coolant. We have filled with coolant. Now we can start the engine. You can see the car has passed 140,000 kilometers. The engine is started, it's working very well. Now we are going to let the engine to work until it reaches working temperature. In the meantime, you can install the protective cover on the engine, and we are leaving open the coolant so the air can go out. When it reaches working temperature at 90 degrees Celsius, we are going to fill if needed, and we are going to close the cap. That's how to change the timing belt on Citroen CLS.